figure out what it says by looking at its case. The different cases represent the part of speech. The part of speech. Is it the subject? Is the noun the direct object? Is it the indirect object? Is it being used with a preposition? Is it being used to show possession? And that helps you to unscramble this puzzle. So the cases tell us everything. You know when you have a puzzle piece and you're putting a puzzle together, you have to look at the edges, right? The center really doesn't tell you anything. The edges tell you everything. Like, is it a corner piece? How many little loops does it have? And that shows you how it fits. In Latin, the cases are your endings. The cases are your edges of your puzzle pieces. They tell you everything. Okay? This chart that we're going to make here, you will be able to recite it in your sleep, because we will use it every single day over and over and over again. If there's only one thing you ever study in Latin, you have to know this cases chart, because everything comes back to it. It is like learning math, and you never learned how to add 1 + 1. You are not going to be able to do any kind of math if you can't do basic addition. You'll never be able to do any kind of Latin if you don't know your cases. So we will make sure to know this, okay? So it'll be overwhelming at first, but then you'll pick it up, because we'll use it so much. Okay, so there are 5 cases. They each have a name. The names are strange. Just go with it. Nominative. Genitive. Dative. Accusative. Ablative. Nominative, genitive, dative, accusative, ablative. They always go in this order. They always go in this order. How do you remember it? Last year, the kids thought of an acronym. No girl dates accused arsonist. No girl dates accused arsonist, right? That's good. You don't want to, right? So no girl dates accused arsonist. If you can remember that sentence, then you can put these in order, right? So what in the world do these words mean? They show us our different parts of speech. So nominative is our subject of our sentence. Guys, none of this will make sense until you see it in action. I know that this is all very strange. The nominative is the subject of the sentence. So if a noun is in nominative case, that's your subject. The boy walks, the boy is the subject. The girl studies, the girl is the subject. Genitive case is if you want to show possession. Somebody owning something. How do you show possession in English? Yeah, with an apostrophe S. What if it's plural? S apostrophe. Okay, for example, if you have dogs, it's the dog's bowl. Dog's bowl. Okay, here is one dog, right? Like a pig. Okay, that's one dog with its bowl. If you have dogs S apostrophe bowl, there are more than one dog there that is ready to eat, right? Because the apostrophe comes after the S. We're going to practice this. also can use the word of, and in Latin we do that a lot. In English we don't. It's the bowl of the dog. It's the book of Thea. It's the desk of Nathan. That's strange. It sounds strange. It's grammatically correct, but it sounds strange. The dative case is your indirect object. This is really hard for you to find in English. Okay, and I have a trick for you. In English, the word to or the word for will always come before the word, before the noun. I baked the cake for the girl. Right there. The girl is your indirect object. Okay. So if it has the word to before it or the word for before it, it's the indirect object. The accusative case is the direct object. It's receiving the action. It receives the action of the verb. What? That sounds strange. I baked the cake. What's receiving the baking? The cake.
Oh.
Picture what's going in the oven. What's receiving the baking? Mary walked the dog. Who's receiving the walk? The dog, right? Mary's the subject. She's doing. Remember, the subject does the action. The subject does the action. The direct object receives the action. Bob punched Sam. That's really important, right? To know who's the subject and who's the direct object. Bob punched Sam. Who's doing the action? Bob, right? Who's receiving the action? Sam. Sam's the direct object, right? Really, he is. Yeah, Bob is definitely the subject. He is doing the action. And then ablative is pretty easy. It is always used with a preposition. Okay, that sounds tough. What's a preposition? Here's a trick for you. It's one of those little tiny words. In, on, by, with, okay? It's a little word, but not two or four, because that's dative, and not of, because that shows possession. This chart is also on the poster on the front board. Okay, for your test, I'll take it down, but after the first couple tests,